The Multnomah County Commissioner is in the news again today. He repeated his feelings on the young people who have fled to Canada to avoid the draft and are now applying to the Multnomah County Registrar of Elections to obtain an absentee ballot.
This should come as a shock to Americans who believe that these young people who deserted their country to avoid the draft now have the gall to ask to vote in our coming election from their sanctuaries in Canada. When the ceasefire is official and the prisoners of war return to America, and when the president grants amnesty to these youngsters, then and only then should they regain their rights, including voting. In the meantime, I say to hell with them.
This is Dan Eilers, KGW Portland News.
When there are only two drumsticks on the table and three drumstick eaters, who gets left out?
The one with the shortest reach.
Is that any way to treat a kid?
No!
Right. No one in Oregon should go without a drumstick. So do what smart moms do. Get smart and get parts. Promise your family the Oregon Fire label on every package of fresh chicken and a drumstick for every mouth.
Get smart, get parts.
It's the good eating thing to do.
Oregon Fire Commission.
Orange, ask for crush. You get the fresher, cleaner, brighter taste of crush. There's only one, there's only one. For 50 years, there's only been one. Orange crush tastes so. Don't ask for orange, ask for crush.
And when you ask for Orange Crush, look for the free Halloween trick-or-treat bag on the Orange Crush display. There's one on every carton of Orange Crush at participating Orange Crush stores.
Peace is hampered in Vietnam again. Hanoi and Washington remain at odds today on whether further negotiations are necessary before an agreement can be signed bringing a ceasefire in Vietnam. Presidential advisor Henry Kissinger has indicated more talks were necessary to complete final details. In Paris, North Vietnamese representatives said there are no remaining questions and insisted on a signing ceremony next Tuesday. More on that for Bernard Kaplan in Paris.
The indications are that North Vietnam will, however reluctantly, agree to another round of negotiations with Dr. Kissinger. North Vietnam is taking the position that the peace agreement is all wrapped up. Their spokesman said here today that their foreign minister is getting ready to fly here next Tuesday to sign it with American Secretary of State Rogers, who, of course, so far as anyone knows publicly, has made no such travel plans himself. Nor are there as yet any signs of preparations here for a peace signing ceremony. The North Vietnamese spokesman said his side would be pleased to meet with Dr. Kissinger again, as he put it, on or before next Tuesday, but he said it would be truly a social occasion to celebrate peace, not to negotiate the outstanding details, which Kissinger says, but which they deny, still remain to be settled. This, however, seemed to be a tactful way of signaling that the North Vietnamese agree to meet again, but won't reopen the negotiations in order to appease South Vietnam's President Chu.
President Chu said today there will be no peace until he personally signs the agreement worked out by the United States and North Vietnam. He'll put the agreement to a vote of his people before signing, he claims. Washington opinion is that there will not resist peace for long. Alvin Rosenfeld reports and analyzes the situation.
There's a growing feeling here that South Vietnam's President Chu will accept the draft peace plan within a short time. Trained observers insist that Chu knows he cannot survive for long without U.S. economic aid. The implication is that the U.S. has hinted it would regretfully withdraw such aid if Chu tried to torpedo the peace plan. But these observers don't think such a drastic step will be necessary. They believe President Chu is trumpeting his opposition to the draft settlement for two reasons: to show his supporters that he fought to the bitter end, and to publicize himself as a true national hero against the day when elections may be held. Having made his public stand, these observers believe Chu will accept the inevitable.
The South Vietnamese military command says during the past 24 hours, the communists have used more mortar and rocket attacks than at any time in the past 4 years. Most of the attacks were on isolated government outposts in the Central Highlands, but the communists are still in evidence some 20 miles from Saigon. Closer to Saigon, villagers are obeying governmental orders to display South Vietnamese flags. William Dowell reports from one of those villages.
The central market and bus station here in Binh Dinh's province capital is only 12 miles north of Saigon. The market is everywhere else now. It's suddenly become alive with yellow and red striped Vietnamese flags. Every house, every shop and store is flying a flag. Every car, bus and truck has one. It looks almost like a victory celebration, but that may be an illusion. Most of the hamlets in Binh Dinh province, briefly overrun by communists 2 weeks ago, have now been cleared. But there's still heavy fighting only a few miles north of here. It's certain that when a ceasefire comes, the communists will claim part of this province is theirs. That will give them the right to operate freely within 10 to 20 miles of Saigon. President Hu still hopes that won't happen, but now a ceasefire seems certain to everyone here, and Hu's government, taking that into account, is desperately trying to make itself as visible as possible everywhere it can.
Democratic presidential candidate George McGovern, campaigning in California today, reaffirmed his support for the current peace effort. The senator said he was grateful for the efforts to bring the Vietnam War to an end in the closing moments of a political campaign.
Now, we all hope that these rumors and reports of peace that we have had over the past 48 hours will prove to be true. No one could be happier than the Democratic presidential candidate if this issue were resolved before we go to the polls on November 7th. The sad note in this whole development is that there seems to be nothing in the present situation that could not have permitted a settlement 4 years ago, roughly along the lines of anything we can hope to accomplish now.
McGovern said he was proud to have been against the war and for peace, even when that was an unpopular position. He said he did not think the American people would forget him. Now for a check on traffic, Jerry Collins with a KGW Skyview traffic report.
Traffic's moving pretty good so far. It's a little heavy southbound the Salem Freeway and eastbound out to Banfield and also Powell Boulevard. I might mention on Powell, westbound between 19th and 16th, there's only one lane available. The right-hand lane has been closed so they can build another little bypass road so they can get to work on this railroad overpass. Jerry Collins, KGW Skyview.
Multnomah County's Rocky Butte Jail has begun some rather important changes. Instead of crowded holding tanks, the jail has set up separate areas to isolate youthful offenders and sexually deviant persons from the general jail population. Another new change involves releasing a prisoner halfway through the booking procedure and having a personal recognizance officer decide if the prisoner can leave and show up later for court appearances. County Commissioner and former Multnomah County Sheriff Don Clark explained for KGW News.
Those people who are a danger to themselves or others or are in danger of great flight, escape, should be kept in jail. All other people should be kept out of jail at all costs. Jail's a traumatic kind of experience. I don't think society is served by locking those people up. It has been in the past that if you had the amount of bail money, you could bail yourself out. But of course, that meant that it was only on economic consideration. And if a person's not going to run off and he's not going to be dangerous, why should he have to put up a large amount of money to get out of jail?
Experience has shown a mere 2% of those persons released fail to show up for court. Lovelorn columnist Abigail Van Buren is campaigning in Oregon today for Republican Senator Mark Hatfield. At a news conference this morning, she talked about how brave Hatfield was 4 years ago when he was opposed to war.
But it was rather unpopular to oppose the president on his stand on the issue of the war in Vietnam. Your Senator Mark Hatfield did just that. And locking horns with the president is usually not a very wise thing to do, but Mark survived it.
She also has some opinions, a bit confusing, but opinions at any rate on the presidential race.
Mr. Nixon, of course, has the experience. Mr. McGovern does not. I think Mr. McGovern is an extremely honest man, because I feel so strongly about the war in Vietnam, and I'm so desperately opposed to it. Naturally, I would be for the man who says, let's get out of here first.
Abigail Van Buren of Dear Abby fame. Baseball Hall of Famer Jackie Robinson, the first black to ever play Major League Baseball, was buried in Brooklyn this afternoon. The Reverend George Lawrence delivered the eulogy.
We thank thee for the great inspiration of thy noble son, our beloved brother, Jackie Robinson, a pioneer of this world who blazed new trails and gave us a new breed of champion. Mounting up with wings as the eagles and charting pathways through dark clouds of bigotry, hatred, and man's inhumanity to man.
The funeral cortege wound its way through Harlem and Jackie Robinson's old neighborhoods. Robinson died Tuesday of a heart attack. He was 53.
Let me give you two very good reasons for buying Sigmund's lunch meats. First, no other lunch meat has Sigmund's quality and flavor. And second, only Sigmund's lunch meats have a resealable snap-on back. This new package reseals leftover slices to keep them fresh and flavorful. So next time, compare. And you'll find two good reasons for choosing Sigmund's Quality Lunch Meats in the new package with a snap-on back.
The smart guys are going layer at JJ's Jeans. At the bottom of it all are the new cheap jeans in uncut cord and fabulous fall colors, topped off with easy care poly cotton shirts and wallpaper prints or knickknacks, and layered with a sweater vest. And to keep it all dry and warm, a smooth glove leather coat. JJ's Jeans, where you can sign up to win a mini Volkswagen, no obligation. JJ's Jeans, Mall 205, Portland Tower Mall, Vancouver, Canyon Road, Beaverton, and Lancaster Mall in Salem. Use your Bank America card.
Updated Portland-Vancouver weather, occasional rain tonight, turning to showers tomorrow, decreasing showers and clearing by Sunday. Lows 35 to 40, highs 50 to 55. Chance of rain 80% tonight and tomorrow, 70% tomorrow night. The five-day forecast, showers. 48 degrees and cloudy, Dan Eilers, KGW, Portland.
Turning to showers tomorrow, decreasing showers and clearing up by Sunday. The overnight lows 35 to 40 and the highs 50 to 55. Our chance of rain is 80% tonight and tomorrow, 70% tomorrow night. In Portland, Vancouver, 48.
WD-40 makes anything that works work better.
The modern non-oily aerosol, WD-40 lubricates to stop irritating squeaks instantly.
WD-40 does hundreds of household jobs, makes sliding doors glide smoothly.
WD-40.
WD-40 penetrates to loosen rusted parts fast.
WD-40 makes household oils obsolete. Clean WD-40 keeps everything working smoothly.
WD-40. Makes anything that works work better.
WD-40 protects metal from rust and corrosion. Keeps tools, guns, fishing gear new, bright.
WD-40 leaves no oily residue. Clean and safe to use on appliances, sewing machines, and zippers.
WD-40.
Look for the blue and yellow can with the bright red top. WD-40. That's WD-40.
WD-40.
Have a nice spray.
Available at J.W. Copeland Yards.
Aren't you getting just a little sick and tired with all the talk about property tax relief and no action? As a voter, here's your chance to do something about property taxes, which have been doubling in Oregon every 10 years. A yes vote on state ballot measure number 9 will cut property taxes an estimated 71% statewide. A yes vote on state measure 9 is a good step in the right direction. Vote yes on measure 9. Paid by the Committee for Measure 9.
Are you in a lather over leather? They've got it at JJ's Jeans. Men's coats in smooth glove leather, single or double-breasted, belted or no belt, solid or antique. Suede jackets in earth colors. Women's leather in suede styles in cinnamon, orange, purple, navy, and more. Check the leathers at JJ's Jeans, where you still have time to sign up to win the mini Volkswagen. No obligation. JJ's Jeans, Mall 205, Portland. Also Vancouver, Beaverton, and Salem. Use your Bank America card.
They took the whole Cherokee Nation, put us on this reservation, took away our ways of life. The tomahawk and the bow and knife took away our native tongue and taught their English to our young. And all the beads we made by hand on our days made in Japan. Cherokee people, Cherokee tribe, so proud to live, so proud to die. Locked us on this reservation. word on time. I'm still part red man deep inside. Cherokee people, Cherokee tribe, so proud to live, so proud to die. But maybe someday when they've learned, Cherokee Nation will return.
You only
52 KGW. This is Mike Rivers and the Phil Harper Show. Going to sweeten things up a little bit. Johnny Nash and I Can See Clearly.
I can see clearly now the rain is gone. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. I think I can make it now. The pain is gone. All of the bad feelings have disappeared.
Better. I can see clearly now. Johnny Nash at KGW 525 with Mike Rivers and Phil Harper. Attention, Gunderson Incorporated shop employees. The plant will not be open this Monday or Tuesday. You might want to check with the plant on Wednesday. Once again, Gunderson Incorporated shop employees only. The plant will be closed Monday and Tuesday, October 30 and 31.
Ladies, this weekend when you open your Sunday newspaper, look for a free surprise from Standard Oil. It's chapter one of the complete family sewing book, which will be available soon at all Standard stations and almost all Chevron dealers. The complete family sewing book is for beginners and experts, with advice on things like new fabrics, alterations, and wardrobe planning. With the easy instructions in this book and your patterns, you can create an economical, original wardrobe for you and your family, even if you don't have a sewing machine. Chapter 2 is also free when you stop in at any Standard station or participating Chevron dealer. In the following weeks, you can collect a new chapter every week for just 19 cents plus tax with any gasoline purchase. Offer including prices may vary at Chevron dealers. Remember to look in this Sunday's newspaper for the free first chapter of the complete family sewing book, a gift from your friends along the Chevron way.
Back in 1878, folks took Rainier beer home in buckets, drank it down and used the buckets over and over. The Northwest first recycling. Later we put our beer in bottles and folks returned them for refilling. More recycling. But in recent years, many containers just got thrown away or became litter. So last year we started recycling again. And now we'll pay you to return Rainier empties so they can be used again and again.
Don't miss the Giant Trans AMA International Motocross of Puyallup, Washington on November 19th, sponsored by Rainier.
Running and hiding all over.
of the city. This is Mike Rivers for Phil Harper with the Raspberries. And I want to be with you.
Stronger than moonshine. You're gonna go. Kenny Loggins and Jim Messina from the album that just flat out bears their name. It's called Loggins and Messina. 5:39 at KGW. This is Mike Rivers.
The case of the missing part of the tumbler. The tumbler was an interesting object indeed. I immediately perceived that this handsome glass was perfect for serving all kinds of cold beverages. I then noted the handsome black plastic holder for the glass. This could be none other than the famous glass snap tumbler by Corning. This much was perfectly clear, but the mystery of the missing part of the tumbler remained. Where was the price? In a flash, I knew there was no price. This extraordinary glass snap tumbler is free with each purchase of $3 worth or more of mobile detergent gasoline from a participating mobile dealer. And many mobile dealers are participating. It's elementary. Consider your beverage serving problems solved.
free tumbler with your purchase from participating mobile dealers in Idaho and Oregon.
When there are only two drumsticks on the table and three drumstick eaters, who gets left out?
The one with the shortest reach.
Is that any way to treat a kid?
No!
Right. No one in Oregon should go without a drumstick. So do what smart moms do. Get smart and get parts. Promise your family the Oregon Fire label on every package of fresh chicken and a drumstick for every mouth.
Get smart, get parts.
It's the good eating thing to do.
Oregon Fire Commission.
Certs. Candy mint, breath mint. It's two. Two. Two mints in one. Certs with Retsin. Stops bad breath.
Oh, if it gets you one, when it gets you again, that is Certs with Certs.
KGW.
Advice for you. These are Eagles. Y'all got to take it easy.